Hi guys, and welcome back to another IBRACORP video. In light of hitting 1,000 subs, I thought I would just get a nice quick one out there for you guys to look at. Something that gets requested quite often, and I thought I would share it just to help you out. As usual, I just want to say a quick thank you to everyone who likes our videos, watches them, subscribes to the channel. It helps immensely. You know, now we've hit 1,000, it's just amazing. So thank you very much. If you haven't subscribed, please consider subscribing if you enjoy what we're doing here and you enjoy our videos. Before you mention it, I have noticed that there are some similar videos to things I've been putting out. And to address that, look, we're here to just put out the best content we can. And if other people want to do something similar, by all means, you know, it's a free world and maybe they have a different way of explaining things. The audience that I cater for by now have realized that I like to just get into things and we address it with an established knowledge. So perhaps there is an audience there that I'm not catering for specifically. For those that I am, thank you for coming back and watching. In today's video, we're going to be looking at ServerAuth with Organizr. And basically this will secure any pages you have by allowing Organizr to intercept them first and then bounce them back to you. It's built into Organizr and it's free of charge. If you haven't watched my Organizr video, I suggest you do that first because we won't be looking at installing it again. We're just going to pick up where we left off, but I'll be using my live environment just to show you how quick it is. So without further ado, let's get into it. So we're here on the server auth page for Organizr, and it has a whole bunch of explanation about how it all works. But I'm here to save you guys time from reading this because I've already read it. So if you want to check it out, I've got the link in the description. Feel free to click it there and have a more thorough read. But quite briefly, all you need to know for what we're doing today, Organizr has built in groups from 0 through to 4, starting with admin through to user. It also has a 998 and 999, so logged in users and guests. This will come important later. We'll go down to Nginx Proxy Manager because that's what we'll be using today. Here's what it basically tells you what you need to put in and where you need to put it. But I've got some advanced config that I'll give you so that you can have some extra error pages and things like that. So let's ignore this for now and I'll just show you straight up what I've got in a live environment so you can see for yourself. So we're here in Nginx Proxy Manager and we're looking at our Sonar installation. This is our proxy for Sonar. Everything looks pretty standard as you can tell. We go to custom locations, here's what you need to do. So click add a location, it's going to ask you to put in a location. So put in this here. All right. Under the host name, put the IP address of the server where Organizr lives, followed by API/v2/auth?group=$1. I'll put this all in the description, guys. You don't have to remember it. I realize you're not all parrots. So under the gear icon, we'll click that. It expands and allows you to put some custom config. So in here, you'll need to put this proxy pass and proxy set header exactly as it is. Underneath, this is an extra section here that I really want to reiterate for those who are using anything that has a API endpoint. Sonar is one of those things. Other applications that might have an API, for example, Jacket has an API, Radar has an API, anything like that, you'll need to put this in here. All right, Jellyfin is another good example too. The reason why is because if you don't put this in here, if you try to use a mobile app or anything that tries to connect via an API, it will keep getting bounced to Organizr. And in some cases, you're not actually able to sign in. Okay, and it's just annoying. Now, if you're putting an API in, you're saying, look, I don't need anything coming through an API to be authenticated because you've already put in an API token somewhere. So it should technically already be authenticated. So just add API here like you see it. You've got your forward host name slash API. If you had your domain in here instead, sonar.ibracorp.io/API, for example, that's the part you add. The port number of Sonar. And if we click the gear icon again, we want auth_request off. So just put that in there. I didn't add before, this port here is the port of your Organizr installation. Alrighty. With that done, head over to advanced, and under advanced, you're going to put this code into your advanced section. When we mentioned the groups earlier, we had auth 0 through to 4. This is where you would put that code. So auth 0 basically means only admins have permission to access this page. So if they were to hit sonar on my website, it would bounce them to Organizr. They would then be asked to sign in. And then if even after signed in, if they're not an admin, they won't get access. All right, but the other options you had was guest access or logged in users. So you can allow, you know, anyone who's logged into Organizr to get access as well. The parts you'll need to edit are just this part here. So your domain where Organizr lives. All right, in my case, it's the hub, but yours might just be whatever.com, for example, wherever you are hosting Organizr. And we covered that in our Organizr video already. So you need to change that here to make sure it's matching your environment. Here as well, and here as well. And I'll put all this in the description below. Once you've done that, click save. The next part you'll need to do is edit your actual Organizr config here in Nginx Proxy Manager as well. So we'll scroll up and we'll grab that. So here's our config for Organizr in our environment. This is what we've got set up for it. As you can see, that's the port as we set up earlier. Head to custom locations. And you'll need to add this in here as well. So we're defining this location, same code that we put in before, adding internal proxy set header. Then under advanced, you don't need to put anything. So basically you're saying this is the main page. This is where we are directing this location to. Once you've done that, that's pretty much it, guys. I'll show you what that looks like now. As you can see, we're on our hub page. This is our members only hub page, and I'm not logged in, so I'm just a guest. So I'm gonna try and hit our sonar page and see what happens. As you can see, we've tried to hit the page and it's bounced us back and it's telling us unauthorized. We don't belong here. So we'll just click OK. Now we'll actually sign in. And you'll see that it automatically straight away sends us back to our sonar page for us. So it redirects us for us. So if you were looking at something like Orthelia and it wasn't your cup of tea, maybe you didn't want a whole new setup for authorization and authentication, Organizr can handle that for you too, and it does a great job at it. So I'd recommend that as an option if you're interested. As I said, there's more on the documentation page if you want to have a read of it, but that pretty much covers how to do that. And it works really well, as you can see. You know, from now, basically all you need to do, or any other ones that you wanted to secure, is just go into the settings, add a custom location. If it has an API, allow the API through, and I'll just expand those again for you. And then in advanced, we add this code, and that's it. So I hope that was helpful. If you need any more information, drop it down in the comments below. Please don't forget to like and subscribe. We really appreciate your patronage, and we'll see you in the next IBRACORP video.